Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello everyone, today I am again with you to deliver a brief description for the class 11th English Literature, and we are having two books, Hornbill and Snapshot. And today we will begin with Hornbill, and the first chapter is The Portrait of Lady. Children, the name itself is very interesting, The Portrait of a Lady. So when we say a word portrait, what does a word means portrait? Portrait means large paintings of the full structure of the human, like the as it we look someone, the same size of the painting is done by hand painting, and that is called a portrait. When there were kings and the queens, they used to make the big portrait, and the portraits were hung in the houses. So we have the chapter name The Portrait of a Lady, means a large painting, handmade painting of a lady. But it is just not literally means the painting, but in this story it is like a full description of a lady. The lady is the grandmother of the writers. It is the writer's grandmother, and portrait is a large painting. Now who is the writer of this story, interesting story? It is Khushwant Singh. I will tell you something in detail about Khushwant Singh. He is an Indian writer. He writes short stories based on Indian society, cultural tradition, and just the emotions also, full of emotions also. He was not only an Indian writer, he was a politician, a lawyer, and a very famous novel that he wrote was Train to Pakistan, which he has won Padma Bhushan also. So he is a very renowned Indian story writer. Okay, so what is the main idea of this story, what is the main theme of this story, is that it is showing the bonding between the writer grandmother, the grandmother and the writer, how they share a very special bond, how they are connected to each other, and what are the stages that come into their life, what are the changes from childhood to the younger and to the adult stage, what happens when they live in the village, then they move to the city, and then what happens when in the end of the story. So we will go to the points and everything. So our story starts with the brief description of the writer's mother. The writer is very fond of her grandmother, and he lives in the village with his grandmother. His parents had moved to the city, mother and father, because they are looking for a better condition of living, job and other facilities, while he has been left with his grandmother in the village to study. Okay, so what are the brief description of the grandmother? She is very old, slightly bent. Her body is slightly bent. She is not walking straight, because old people, you might have seen, they are slightly bent, and with the help of the stick they are walking. So she is very old, and she is slightly bent, and she has completely white long hairs, and she has a wrinkled face, like the old people are having face full of wrinkles. And she is a very religious lady. Religious lady means always chanting hymns and reading religious books and everything, and she has a rosary bead, and she is always chanting the mantras and everything. So she always engaged in religious activities. So just the writer says that I can never imagine my grandmother might be somewhat younger in some age, because he has always seen his grandmother like this, and she is a very beautiful lady in the eyes of the writer, although she is a very old lady. Then there is a portrait of the grandfather also in the house, and it is hung above the fireplace in the main hall. He is also very old, looks like a very 100-year-old man, with having a long white the beard and the mustache. But he is no more, the portrait is there, and grandmother, she is taking care of the writer. So what happens, the first phase of the writer and the grandmother's, the relation, what is the relation? The village life, while they were living in village, is the first phase of their relationship. Like what were the things the grandmother was doing to the writer, what she was doing for him? She wakes him up in the morning, makes him breakfast, and gets him ready for the school. And usually in the breakfast, he was eating chapati with the sugar or jaggery, and he was rolling up and he was eating in the breakfast. And then the grandmother used to make him ready for the school. And school was near in the temple only, near the temple only. And they two together were walking with each other to the temple. This was the basic daily routine of there in the morning. They were walking together to the school. While going together to the school, they were carrying the stale chapatis. Stale chapatis for the stray dogs. Stale chapatis means they were carrying whatever amount of chapatis are left, they are carrying with them. And when they reach the school, the grandmother goes to the temple and she reads religious books. By that time, the writer is in the school of the within the temple only, and he is studying the religious books and alphabetical and mantras in the that time only. When the school gets over, they both come together, and while they are coming, many of the stray dogs follow them, because daily they are giving them stale chapatis, and this was the daily routine of them. They come back together to the home. So this was basically, and when they come to the home, the grandmother always help him with his school work and is making him understand, learning, helping him learn the religious books, the mantras and the Vedic scriptures. Means all the religious things, whatever help he was needing, grandmother was helping him with the books. So this was the first phase of their relationship. With this was the first village life what they were doing. So children, as I have told you, the writer and the grandmother, they were living in the village. And they were sharing a very close bond together. The writer was very young and he was fully dependent on his grandmother. Now after some time, when the parents in the city, they got settled up, they called both of them to the city. Okay, now they moved, the grandmother and the writer, they moved to the city and they were started living in the city. So children, what happened in the city, how they are born, what changes comes into their bond, what is the relationship between them now? While they were in the city, it was a turning point. Turning point means some things changed a lot. What the things were changing? The writer went to an English medium school. Previously, he was studying in a religious school in the temple. He was reading religious scriptures and everything. But now he is going to a English medium school, and there were new subjects. New subjects, what were they? Science, mathematics were there, and music was also there. So the grandmother was not at all happy because she didn't knew anything about these new subjects, science and mathematics and music, and she was not able to help the writer in the work, school work or the homework. And she didn't like that the music was taught to them in the school, because according to her, music was not a good thing for the people of the higher classes. It was something for the lower classes. So she was not happy with it because she was not able to help in studies. Now, what were the changes in the behavior of the grandmother came after this all happened, when she was not able to connect with the child? She confined to herself, means she was to herself only. She didn't talk too much, she talks very less, and always busy in chanting hymns and mantra or the religious things, reading scriptures. And when she was in the village, she was offering the stale bread to the stray dogs, and this was her routine. But now in the city, these people are not having, in the neighbors, they are not having any stray dogs. So here she, in the evening time, after the prayer in the evening or in the afternoon, she used to offer bread pieces to the sparrow. she was offering bread to the sparrow, and the sparrows were daily coming to her as a routine. They were coming to her and they were having the bread which she was giving in the afternoon. Now, what happens after that? When the writer grows up, he goes to college for the higher studies. For the higher studies, he went to the college, and there was no connection between the grandmother and the writer, because the writer was now living in a separate room. Now he was an adult and he has a separate room because he has more studies he has to do, and he was going to college. He was having a separate room, and the grandmother was still there because she has nothing to do. She was having the same routine, chanting mantras, religious book, reading religious books, and offering bread to the sparrows in the afternoon. Now, after that, what happens from the city life, changing behavior, higher studies? Then, after that, the writer now goes to the foreign country for the furthermore studies. Now, what happened? He has to go to the foreign country for a period of 5 years. He has to go for 5 years for his studies. Now, whole family came with the grandmother to bid goodbye to the airport. And she hugs him tightly, but she doesn't say anything. She says nothing. She says nothing, just hugs him tightly, and she is having no words to say him. And finally, the connection between the writer and the grandmother is broken. The connection is broken between them, and the writer is not sure to see the grandmother after the period of long 5 years. When he comes, he imagines that if I come after 5 years, will I be able to see the grandmother, as she was very, very old and she might die also. So this might be his last meeting with the grandmother. Okay children, the further description of this chapter. I have told you about the first phase of the life of the writer and the grandmother when they were living in the village. Second phase, when they came to the city, what were the turning point of the coming in the city? What was the turning point? And third phase, when he went to college, and then for the further studies to the foreign country. Now the last stage, what happens in the end? After 5 years, when the writer comes back to India, or with the family, the grandmother comes to receive him, and she now looks, when they come home, she is in a different mood. When they come to their home, back to their home with the writer, the grandmother is seen in a different mood. What mood? What kind of mood? She is having a mood of contentment, satisfaction, and she looks happy. Then today the new thing happens in these years, long years. That day she doesn't pray. This is the day when she skips the chanting and praying. She doesn't pray that day. What she does? She calls the neighboring ladies, all the ladies from the neighborhood. She calls them, and now they started singing the songs and beating drums, like the songs that are sung for the homecoming of the warriors. So for the great people, when they come home after victory, those songs were sung for the writer, and the drum, the ladies were beating drums and singing songs, and the grandmother also was doing, she was beating the drums and singing the song. What happens after that in the evening? The outcomes of this, her health is disturbed. She falls ill, and she is taken to the bed where she knows that her end was near. She is going to die. She knows that she is going to die, and she says that all the family members, that I don't want to waste any time. Please, you go from here, and I want to spend my last breath in chanting the hymns and the mantras and praying to God. And while she is chanting mantras on her rosary beads, suddenly the rosary beads fall and she passes away. She finally dies. When, as a tradition, the dead body is taken and to the floor, And when the body is taken to the veranda where the body is kept on the floor, at that time, there in the morning, the birds came. The sparrow whom the grandmother was offering the breadcrumbs, and all the sparrow, when seeing the body of the grandmother, they come close and sit very silently. Next morning, the bird came near the body. They sat silently for a few minutes, and while they were sitting, the mother thought they had come for the daily routine. They wanting the bread, so mother just scattered the breadcrumbs over there. But the birds didn't eat any of the peas. They sat silently and flew away without taking or eating the breadcrumbs. They didn't eat anything. It looks they were very sad. They understood everything. So this shows, this act of the sparrow shows their attraction and affection towards the grandmother, and this attraction affection of the birds towards the grandmother, which is now she has died. So this whole story, the portrait of a lady, just tells us the human emotions, the connection between the family member, the grandchildren and the parents, and also of the animals and the birds towards the other people or human beings. So this is a natural thing to happen, and we must able to understand the connection of a grandmother to the grandson. And the Kushwant Singh is very successful in telling us the carrying his emotions in the story and making us understand, and I hope that you people have also understood the story. So children, explanation of the chapter is over. I have explained you the main topics and the points and the events of the chapter, the portrait of a lady, the main phases of their life, the village phase, the city phase, and when he goes to the higher study, and how and why, in what circumstances the grandmother dies. Now children, the chapter is over, and I hope that you have understood. Now, if you practice this short questions also along with the textual question, this will be helpful to you. So I am giving you very short questions of this chapter, chapter number 1, Portrait of a Lady. The question number 1, give the character sketch of the grandmother. Character sketch means whatever I have told you, how the grandmother was looking, whatever the physical appearances, about what I have told you or you have read in the chapter, that you have given a very short form, brief form. Second question, how did the grandmother help the writer in the village? What were their basic routine? When the writer was very small, very young, how the grandmother used to do everything for him, that you have to tell in this answer. Question number 3, compare the village and the city life of the grandmother. Now you have to give a contrast of the village life, how she was spending the days with the writer, her grandson, and how she was having a relation in comparison to the village and the city. So you have to tell the difference or the comparison of the this one, of the city and the village life. Question number 3. Question number 4, when did the grandmother miss her prayers for the first time? She was a very religious and a pious lady, but for the first time she skipped her praying. She doesn't pray that day. What was that day and what was the reason behind that day? That you have to write in this answer. Now question number 5, why did the sparrow not pick up the breadcrumbs the last day? So what happened at the last day of the story, and the sparrows came and sat near that grandmother's body, but they didn't eat or take any of the breadcrumbs. What was the reason? And you have to just tell in a very short form. So children, these 5 questions I have given you, assessment for you given you along with the regular questions that you will be having in your books, and that you have to practice. So I hope this would be helpful to you and you are able to understand the lesson. Thank you all.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.